Hello. Moving on, in the series where we were discussing roots, prefixes and suffixes, we today discuss how prefixes help us to understand and learn more about unfamiliar words. I've picked up prefixes on the basis of whether they are negative or positive. So one way in which a prefix tells you a lot about a word is by giving you a feel of whether the word is positive or negative. Look at the common negative prefixes. For first one, I picked up un. Now all the negative prefixes, un, in, ill, ir, and dis, they all mean not or opposite of. So let's look at un and the words created out of un. So if we add un, the prefix to limited, then we have not limited. So all these prefixes give you a clear indication if it is unlimited, uncovered, then it is not covered, not limited. Similarly with in, im, the prefix intolerant, inefficient, with im, impossible, implausible. Now implausible, something which is beyond reasonable. So we cannot reason this out and hence it is implausible. Then ill will give you illegal, illiterate, means without any legal background or something which is done without the consent of law, and illiterate means without being literate. Then ir gives you irregular and irrelevant, meaning the same in context. And we move to the other one, which is dis. Dis now gives you disagree, discontent, connect, discontent. So all this will mean that it is without content, connect or agreement. Let's look at the common positive prefixes. So these are prefixes which are commonly giving you positive vibes. So these words created out of all these prefixes will be positive in outlook, in meaning and in attitude. AMM will give you, which means friend, will give you amicable, amiable. Have you heard of amicable solutions? So whenever there is conflict, whenever there are two sides contending one cause, there are people who also try to find an amicable solution to it. So amicable basically is a friendly solution to conflicts. Amiable person is a friendly person. Similarly, B-E-N, Ben, or B-E-N-E, Ben, both mean good. So anything which begins with Ben or Ben is usually good. It is positive. Hence the words benefit, benevolent, beneficiary, all these words come from the prefix which means good. The third one, cred, means belief, and with belief, credulous, credibility. The fourth one, emm, means into. So the meaning is into. So empower is you are putting power into something. So you are endorsing that power. Similarly, embark is somebody who is boarding a flight or a ship. He is getting into a flight or a ship. The fifth one is pro. Now pro means forward. So it is a movement towards a propulsion towards the front. And then you have the words procedure and process. In the sixth one, you have viv. Now viv means life. And hence the word vivacious, a personality which is full of life. Vivid is a kind of lively, colorful event or thing. The second thing that I wish to discuss in this session would be the meaning of prefixes also help you to determine the meaning of unfamiliar words. Now look at these prefixes. Suppose you have the prefix MB. So MB, the meaning says on both sides. And then the words which will start with MB naturally will have two sides to think of. So ambivalent is having two opposite conflicting emotions or beliefs at the same time. So simultaneously you are holding two conflicting beliefs. Similarly, ambidextrous. Now here MB means both and dextrous means skill. So ambidextrous, when it combines and comes to you, the meaning of the word becomes that a person who is proficiently or is able to work with both his hands. Come to the next prefix here, medi. Medi means middle. Now all the words that come would not be at either extremes. It will always be in the middle. So mediate, a person who gets inside or intervenes a conflict to find a solution to it. Mediocre, Now mediocre, of ordinary quality. So neither very good nor very bad. Medium is again somewhere in between, not in the extreme ends. And the last one that we are discussing today in this session would be sin. Sin means together or with. So all the words here always will signify something that is happening together. So synergy is the occurrence of energy together. Similarly, synthesis is the separation of elements, and when they are together working into one whole, then it is called synthesis. Syntax is the arrangement of words together to form a meaningful sentence. I hope this session on prefixes helps you in identifying the unfamiliar words that you come across when you are preparing for vocabulary. Thank you so much.